not here tonight, so he does have a couple of communications under his, so I guess I will read those. Oh, I'm sorry. I'd like to make, or can I get a motion to accept the agenda?
Yes, Mr. Chair, I'd like to make a motion to accept the agenda with the following changes. First one being that we would like to do a consent agenda for items number 10 through 12. And the second one being item number 18, we want to change the motion to read, motion to approve City of Taylor, other post-employment benefits, OPEB, actuarial evaluation, and corresponding GASB 75 reports as of June 30th, 2018.
We got a motion by Councilwoman Croft, supported by Councilwoman Pass. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion passes. Okay, at this time, Mayor Saunders is not here tonight, so he does have a couple under Mayor's communication. Excuse me, I'm jumping ahead of here. I apologize, everybody. Can we have an acceptance of the minutes held on January 2nd, 2019, and dispense with the oral reading?
I'll make that motion.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Pax. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion passes. Okay, now at this time. I apologize, everybody. Mayor Communications tonight, we have 5A. Can I have a motion to approve the appointment of Councilwoman Angela Croft to the Risk Management Commission term to expire November 3rd, 2021?
I'll make that motion.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Pass. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion passes.
Hi, Angela Croft.
Hi, Angela Croft.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the State of Michigan.
The Constitution of the State of Michigan.
The Charter of the City of Taylor.
The Charter of the City of Taylor.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
Of the office of.
Of the office of.
Risk Management Board Member.
Risk Management Board Member.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Also have a 5B under Mayor's communication, and I have a motion for McMillan Group Inc. low quote for the demolition of two dangerous buildings in the amount of $17,500 plus a 1% contingency for total amount of $19,250 funded through the Community Development Block Grant. Excuse me, that's 10% contingency.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Pass. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Say no. Motion carries. That is all we have for the mayor's communication, so we'll move on to the regular agenda. Okay. Item number 6. Can I have a motion to approve the purchase of new fire hose from West Shore Fire, low bid, for the amount not to exceed $48,833. Purchase will be funded through with 3-year lease agreement through PNC Bank and to approve budget amendment 2019-013. Purchase will be funded through Fire Capital Outlay Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Croft, supported by Councilman Mazura. Is there any discussion? 7 is a motion to approve purchase of Pierce ladder truck from Halt Fire Inc, preferred vendor, for the amount of $696,145, which includes the trade-in of the old ladder truck. Purchase will be financed with a three-year lease agreement through PNC Bank. The trade is contingent on approval from the Taylor Building Authority. Purchase will be funded through the Fire Capital Outlay Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion from Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 8, can I have a motion to approve purchase of heart monitors from Physio Control, preferred vendor, for the amount not to exceed $68,993? Purchase will be financed with a three-year lease agreement at PNC Bank, funded through Fire Capital Outlay Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Croft, supported by Councilman Johnson. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chair, I just want to let the residents know that all three of these here, it sounds like a lot of money, but with the three-year lease purchase agreement, there is money in the Fire Outlay Account, Fire Capital Outlay Account, just to let you know.
Is there any more discussion? All those opposed say yes, or I'm sorry, all opposed say yes. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 9, motion to approve the purchase of new extraction equipment from Apollo Fire Equipment Company, lowest responsible bid, for the amount of $94,550. Purchase will be financed through a three-year lease purchase agreement through PNC. Purchase will be funded through Capital Outlay Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion?
Last night, when we had our study session, information that we received on this was that the fire department, the gentleman, the fireman that actually used this equipment tested it. So, you know, we're going to take, because they're the ones who are going to be using this equipment. And also, again, this is a three-year lease.
All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 10 is a motion to approve amending the 2018 winter special assessment rule by removing 870 weed special assessment charges from 9786 Princess per attached documents. We are doing this in a consent agenda, so my apologies. So 9 through 12 is a consent agenda. These are special assessments that will be removed by council because of, we cannot prove that the work was done.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
Councilman Mazur.
I believe all of these are rental properties, is that correct? Or maybe Mr. Markey can speak to this status. I know he sent a communication to us. Possibly rentals that aren't properly registered in the city.
Chairman, City Council, and Councilman Mazur. That is correct. Earlier this morning, I spoke to Jamie McCarty to confirm two things. One, from my office, that the homestead exemption on place, and they are not, all three are not homestead properties. So then we researched the three parcels to see if they had rental certificates. And one of them does not have a rental certificate. We do not know if it's occupied. That's the question that we still have to get further clarification on. If it's vacant and not rented out, it's not mandated to have a rental certificate. It's recommended in case they ever want to let it out. The other two houses, for our investigation, one had a rental certificate through 2017 that is currently in place and is in compliance with the
now that this has been brought to our attention, I think we should definitely make sure the appropriate city department reacts to any rentals that aren't properly registered, don't have the proper certificate. So, separate issue, but we're looking at three properties. If these properties are not following a particular city code ordinance, I hope that we're going